Ladies and gentlemen, that's our secondary bells program. Give them one last round of applause while they clean up. I could have your attention just for a few seconds for some general announcements, and then of course I'll read a verse of scripture while they clear out their stuff so that the choirs can come in. Number one, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Frederick Christian Academy and to our Christmas concert here this evening. We are so very thankful for each and every one of you, whether you're watching from our overflow section in the gymnasium or whether you came early enough to actually get one of the coveted seats in the auditorium here today. Congratulations. Very first thing I need you to do this evening is to take out your cell phone for me, and if you could put it on silent, that would be a blessing, so that all of the attention tonight can be, of course, for our students and for our Savior, rather than on your amazing Christmas ringtones that you got going on for yourselves. That'd be a wonderful blessing right there. I appreciate it. Of course, you're welcome to take video or pictures here this evening. Just please no flash photography, and we would appreciate those things. A couple of other quick announcements. If anybody needs to use the restroom, the closest restrooms are to the back of the auditorium, just to the left in the hallway that is there. Many of you will be familiar with the restrooms that are near the gymnasium in our main secondary hallway, but there are some just to the back of the auditorium in the hallway to the left. For those of you with the little ones that I hear, if you need a changing table, our church nursery is in the back of the foyer to the very back left-hand side, and so there's a changing table there in the church nursery. Also, if there's any time that tonight your little one needs to go and have a place just to run around, once again, we have a 10.5-foot screen in our overflow section, so you can, it's as close as you can be to being in the live performance without being in the live performance, and then they can run around in the gymnasium, and it's a good second option for that right there. Next up would be, as a general reminder, at the end of the program tonight, after Pastor Ramler closes the program out, everybody is invited to the gymnasium, one, to pick up your children. We would appreciate that very much, so that at some point we can go home. But two, of course, for a time of fellowship and camaraderie, we do have hot chocolate and some cookies. I think there may be coffee for those of you that can handle caffeine late at night, and we'll just have some good fellowship. The PTA today does have some leftover items from the week's Christmas shop, and so they are available for your look and purchase if you would like to at the back of the auditorium. And then lastly, there is a donation box. Every Christmas concert, we take up a collection for our faculty and staff. So anything that you give tonight, know that it's a supplement to our faculty and staff Christmas bonus. All monies will go directly to them. Last thing I want to mention before I read a verse of scripture, something a little bit different today. In your program, there is a carol sing sheet, and there's a section where there's going to be four different songs where the fourth through sixth grade are going to be singing, and feel free, if you desire, to sing along with them. I think the lights are going to come on at that time, but I don't know if you'll be cued other than that, but if you would like to sing the First Noel and some of the others with them, by all means, join right on in and be a part of our Christmas concert here this evening. All right. Let's center in real quick on the real reason for Christmas and the reason why we put on a Christmas concert. I'd like to read just a couple of verses for you from Luke chapter 2. I'll start in verse 6. In Luke chapter 2 and verse 6 it says, "And so it was, that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." Ladies and gentlemen, it is my prayer this evening that you would have an experience somewhat like the shepherds, where you'd be brought face to face with the glory of our God as he alone is high, and that your response would be just like those angels, glory to him, of course, as we celebrate the birth of our Savior by ringing in Christmas. Without further ado, let's invite our primary choir.
dashing, dashing, dashing through the snow. In a wondrous, wondrous open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, o'er the fields we go. Laughing, 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 yes, we're laughing all the way. The sunbolts and bells on gold and ring, making spirits bright. Thank you.
Well, I have to say that those children were very talented. I could not do a tone. I can't even say tone chime. I could not play a tone chime and sing at the same time. That was remarkable. And to see what the children have learned in just a few months. Now, I'm not surprised. I've been listening to it for the last 3 months. My office is right there as they've been practicing. But they did a great job tonight. Of course, the whole reason for us having a program like this is not simply to showcase the incredible music talent of our young people, but it is primarily to promote our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Those verses that were read at the beginning of the program tonight, that a baby would be found in Bethlehem who is a Savior, Christ the Lord. You know, my friend, if you are here tonight and you are not 100% sure that all your sins are forgiven, that's why a Savior came to this world. 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ took upon himself, God took upon himself human flesh, that he might be born, that he might live on this planet for 33 years, that he might die on a cross to pay for your sins, to pay for my sins. And so we rejoice in the bleak midwinter of hope that comes as a result of Jesus Christ's birth. The Bible says that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And again, if you're here tonight and you're not 100% sure that all your sins are forgiven, you know the Bible says that these are written in the book, God's Word, these are written that you might know that you have eternal life, that you might have forgiveness of sins. And I invite you tonight, if you'd like to get that matter settled, please come talk to me, my wife, Mr. Lavoie. There's no greater joy that comes than having a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. That's what we're teaching our children. What a wonderful thing it is to be able to have your children in a Christian school where you can actually talk about God in a favorable way, right? Where you can actually praise Jesus Christ by name and not hear it as a curse word. And so we're thankful for you willing to partner with us here at Frederick Christian Academy to raise up the next generation of Christian soldiers for God's glory. And so tonight, we'll have in just a moment a word of prayer, but I'd like to say a big, big thank you to Tricia Sturm and all the work she did in putting this program together. Let's give her a round of applause. I have to be honest, I was a little skeptical when you started with the hand chimes, but it all came together. Very good. And then, of course, so thankful for our piano players tonight, for Lori and for Jean. Let's give them a round of applause as well. And then somebody you didn't see, and that's a good thing, was Johnny Rebert, who helped with the parking lot stuff and the sound and the lights and just overall did everything that needed to be done. So big thank you to Johnny in the back. In just a moment, like I said, in just a moment, we're going to have a word of prayer, but I do want to invite everybody down to the gymnasium afterwards to pick up your children especially, but also free of charge, there is hot chocolate. There are cookies. You're not going to have to pay for that. There is a Christmas store, I believe, some items still available. You can purchase those items. And then I think right after I pray, Mr. Lavoie has the license plate number of a car that must be moved. All right, so let's have a word of prayer, and then we'll have Mr. Lavoie embarrass one person in this auditorium. And we really do need you to move your car, like, right as soon as we tell you, okay? So let's have a word of prayer, and then we'll be dismissed. Father, we're thankful for the opportunity tonight to praise the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I cannot emphasize how important it is to have a personal relationship with Jesus, to have our sins forgiven, to have the Lord as our Savior. And that is what gives us hope in the bleakness of this world all around. Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace. Jesus Christ is the King of Righteousness. Jesus Christ is eternal life. And those who have their life placed in His hands have the hope of a resurrection. Tonight, may no one leave the premises without knowing for sure their eternal destiny. Lord, we're thankful for Jesus Christ. We're thankful for our teachers here. We're thankful for our parents who have partnered with our teachers to train up these young people to not only love the Lord with all their heart, soul, mind, and strength, but to love their neighbor as their self. Lord, we need young people. We need old people like that today to make a difference. And so, Lord, we're thankful for the hot chocolate, for the cookies we're about to partake. And, Lord, I pray that you would give us safety as we go home. And through all of this, Lord, may we never forget the greatest gift of all, Jesus Christ. For it's in His name we pray. Amen.